Hey robot makers, do you want to add wireless charging to your robot projects? Then keep watching. So let's have a look at what we're going to learn in this session today. So this is all about wireless charging. I would say this is an intermediate level skill. We're going to learn about what is wireless charging, how it works, what you'll need, and some do's and some don'ts. So electric toothbrushes have been doing this for years. You might realize when you plug your toothbrush into its little base station that uses induction to charge the toothbrush's battery. So what is wireless charging? It's the transfer of current between two physically separate circuits through electromagnetic induction. What we'll need for this is a charging coil and a power supply, a receiving coil, and they do come in pairs. One has a slightly longer piece, and then there's one that has a shorter, squarer piece. So the squarer piece is the transmitter. This is what you plug your bench power supply or your transmitting power. And then the tall, thin one is the receiver. This is the one that you're going to put onto your robot. So how does it work? So an induction to induction. So current from a power source energizes the coil, creating a magnetic field. Another coil that's placed within that field will pick up the energy and transfer it to its own circuit. There will be some small power loss, and depending how far away the coils are from each other, that will also define what that loss will be. The coils do need to be in close alignment to work well, and this is Faraday's law of induction. So what you'll need is a pair of charging coils, they're around $8 to $9, a LiPo battery, and a LiPo battery charging board, such as the Adafruit micro-lipo, and a power source to run the charger from. So I'm using a bench power supply. So over in Fusion 360, I've designed a coil holder for the robot. So there's two parts to this. There's a part that's going to attach to the bottom of the robot, and then there's going to be the dock that the robot can roll over. These two channels will guide in the bottom of the robot so that the coils perfectly align and the power is transferred optimally. Okay, once we've designed this, what I'll do, I will save out the chassis piece as a mesh, and I shall save that as a STL binary. So I'm going to save the top and the bottom of the charging dock. Then next up I'm going to open up Cura, and then I'm going to slice this so that I can 3D print it. Okay, so I'm just going to come over here, I'm going to open up all three bits. I would actually print these one at a time rather than all together, but just to show you here, this is what we can do. So I do like to flip these over just so that they're oriented best way for 3D printing, and similarly with that piece, like so. So let's slice that, and it'll probably take it a couple of hours to print that out. But you can see there, we've got the pieces ready to go. Here's an example of how the wireless charging works. So I have two coils here. One is the transmitter and one is the receiver. And I've got a little microbit here, and it's not got any battery on it, it's literally got these two crocodile clips here, and it's got the receiver there. And if you watch in the top right of the screen, you'll also see the power supply that I've got, my bench power supply here. So as I move this coil into alignment, you can see that the microbit comes to life and runs its Hello World program. And then as I move it away, you'll see it fades out. So I'm probably about a centimeter in height. And you can see there it's drawing about 7 milliamps. And as I move it away, the LEDs get dimmer, drawing 6 milliamps, and then it doesn't provide enough power. So I've now got a microbit wired up to this little micro-lipo from Adafruit, and I've got a LiPo battery here as well. So currently the battery is not charging, it's just providing power to the microbit. Now if I align the coil over the transmitter coil, you'll see on here the LEDs will come to life and the battery will start to charge. We can see there on the display, it's now beginning to draw a little bit more current. So we can see there on the microbit, the program continues to run whether we're charging or not, because this little board in between sort of negotiates whether it's drawing power from the battery, whether the battery is being charged and so on. So we remove power from that, you can see the charge lights go out, but the battery remains providing power to the microbit. So what we do have to bear in mind is the orientation of the coils. So the coils have to be in alignment, parallel to each other. If I move this out so it's just half over, you can see there that it's not drawing enough, it's not providing enough power. The field isn't powerful enough. So it just has to be slightly over halfway for it to be within the field. And the more over, more direct it is, the more power will be provided. If the coil is at an angle, 90 degrees juxtaposition, again, that's not correct, that won't work. If I tilt it, you'll see at a certain point when it's almost parallel, the power will be provided once again. So what I want to do, I want to have a robot, such as this SMARS robot here. I want to put on the bottom of that a wireless charger, and I want to have a base station. Robot will roll over, and the little nub on the bottom there will align perfectly with the coil on the bottom. So both coils will be perfectly aligned. So what I've designed in Fusion 360, I'll show you a prototype version here, is a holder for the bottom coil. So the idea here is we have the coil, and see this one's not quite the right dimensions there, but this version which I've constructed is the correct size. So there's two little channels there. They don't actually have to be separate, these, they can be touching, that's not a problem. And then the wires just come out of the holder at the bottom. And then over the top of this, there's just a plate. And what I've designed in Fusion 360 is this sort of nub at the bottom here. As this drives into position, that will align the coil. It doesn't matter what orientation that is, as long as it's hit there, and that will align both coils perfectly over each other. So you can see that our little robot's working. So when it drives over the module and it's in the correct alignment, it will start to pick up some power. So then instead of powering the circuit directly there, we need to use that charging circuit so that it can charge the battery. So the battery will sit into the robot. As the robot drives over the module now, it starts to charge the battery. And then we can take another feed from the battery to power our little robot. There's two other little pins on this little circuit, and we can use them to power our robot. So this SMARS robot can either be Raspberry Pi Pico powered, we do have a module to run it through a microbit, or it can be an Arduino. So we've got lots of different options there to run this. So here's the dock. We've got the dock wired up now. So that's got power from the bench power supply. So the coil is underneath there. We have our robot with the coil, the power coming out, going to our little charge module, which is in turn going to power our robot. So as this rolls over the top here, when it gets into alignment, we can see there that the charge has begun. So I hope you enjoyed this video about how to add wireless charging to your robot projects. It's really quite simple. I found this one probably one of the least challenging projects that I've done to date. So buy yourself a bunch of these. They're not that expensive. You can get them in little packs as well. And you can add wireless charging to your robots too. So thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time.